appropriate lighting is given a lower priority in industry than in any other area. Did you know, however, that 80% of the information that people need to do their job in the industry is visual, so the need for good lighting is there. Nevertheless, what we still see a lot in the industry is this situation: bare battens, old-fashioned fluorescent tubes on the ceiling. And in spite of the large number of luminaires installed and the enormous amount of energy spent on lighting, the illumination level barely meets the minimum requirements. If we look at the quality of the light, this does not meet the minimum requirements. Take a look, for example, at this truck cabin. Actually, it is fiery red, but because of the poor quality of lighting, you cannot see it. Even worse, I look pale, and so will everybody who works in this hall. To improve this, we have several options. The first one, of course, is a very simple one, mainly replacing the existing tubes with modern ones. And you see, we have more light. The cabin is now indeed fiery red, and also I look a lot healthier. Nevertheless, also what we have here is still quite an inefficient way to illuminate this hall. We still need a high number of luminaires. Let's have a look at the most efficient way to illuminate this hall, still using fluorescent. What we have here is the most efficient way to illuminate an industry hall, still using fluorescent tubes. The number of luminaires has been decreased by 30%, the illumination level has doubled, and the power consumption is more than halved. Still, we are using rather old-fashioned fluorescent lighting in this case. There is also an LED alternative. And now, we are using even less energy. The energy consumption now has been halved again. Compared to the initial situation, we now have double the amount of light at 1/5 of the power costs. This is what we call line lighting. And this is what we see used a lot. Why? Because the light distribution is very nice. The lighting is very uniform. There are no harsh shadows. There are no stark contrasts. And in the industry, that is what you want. The downside, of course, is that we need still a rather high number of luminaires. Another way of illuminating this hall is using high bays. And for this particular hall, which is 14 by 18 meters, I only have to use 6 luminaires to achieve this. Let's look what this looks like. As we have only 6 light points, we now see an increase in the contrasts and in the shadows. And by the way, did you look at the cabin? It is no longer fiery red. The light source that we use here is a high-intensity discharge lamp. This lamp has a lifetime of approximately 15,000 hours, which in a 24/7 operation means that the lamps will have to be exchanged, let's say, every 1.5 years. And mind you, maintenance, especially in the industry, is a very high cost factor. So if we were able to increase the lifetime of these luminaires, we would have major benefits. Well, we can, because there is an LED alternative to this one. Now we are talking 75,000 hours of lifetime. So the costs of maintenance have decreased enormously. In the industry, we very often see a combination between general lighting and task lighting. In those areas where finer mechanical work has to be performed, we need more light, like in this situation, for example. The need for task lighting is obvious. Let me show you what happens when I switch it off. This is insufficient lighting to do my job properly. On the other hand, if I have good task lighting, do I still need general lighting? Well, judge for yourselves. Would you like to work in an environment like this? I have sufficient lighting here, yes. But if I look around me, the hall is dark, making me feel uncomfortable and also hampering my work. Because as long as I work here, my eyes will adjust to the high lighting levels that we have here. However, at a certain moment, I will have to get new parts, which I have to get back there in the dark area. So my eyes have to adjust to the lower lighting levels. Returning here, I once again have to adjust to the higher lighting levels. And in the end, this will cause fatigue to my eyes and I start making mistakes. Bottom line is, we need a good balance between task lighting and general lighting.
Thank you for watching this video.